Yo! Are you starting a new data project and you're stuck at step zero? Do me a favor. Take a pause and breathe and pick your lane. In this video, I'm going to talk about four options that you have when working with data solutions in Microsoft Fabric. Power BI, materialized views, a warehouse, or Lakehouse. I'm gonna break down the advantages and disadvantages and give you a few simple rules so you don't either rebuild the project later or over-architect your solution. So, you know what I like to do? Enough of all this talking, let's get into this. Before you start designing your data solution, you need to think about what questions are you trying to answer. Of course, you want to create a centralized repository of data. You want the data to be consistent. You want it to be secure, like put a lock and key on it. And you want it to be well governed. But a lot of times we start designing out these data solutions without talking to the people that's going to consume it. We have no idea what questions we're trying to answer. Are we trying to figure out how many widgets are we selling? Are we trying to figure out how many loyalty members making purchases? How many students are coming back next semester? We need to think about these clearly before we start designing the solutions. Once we know the questions we're going to answer, we need to think about how are people going to discover this data? Are they going to just use Power BI? Are they going to use Excel? Are they going to use paginated reports? Are they going to use some other tool? Are we going to have data scientists building out machine learning models doing AI against this data? The solution that you design needs to be able to expose the data in a way that it can be consumed in these different ways. Once we know how people are going to consume this data, we got to talk to everybody, and we try to identify the type and number of all the possible data sources that we need to answer those questions and to make that data discoverable, and try to literally exhaust the possible data sources. It could be from a relational database, a file system that's running on premises, a SaaS application like Dataverse, a Salesforce. It could be cloud databases like Azure SQL, or it could just be flat files like Excel, CSV, JSON, Parquet. This is one of those keys that you need to decide ahead of time, because that's going to decide which lane are you going down. So let's get into these. The first one up, Power BI. Power BI can connect to virtually any data source. It can pull data from anywhere. And then using Power Query, I can massage and transform that data and get really intimate with it and bring it into my semantic model. Then I can create relationships, put some business logic in my DAX, and then I can expose that semantic model to Power BI, to Excel, to Paginated Report Builder, Copilots. I can expose that data to lots of different types of tools, and the people that need to consume it can use those tools to consume it. And there's some big advantages to it, because Power BI is very, very user-friendly. It's easy to get started. You can do rapid prototyping. It's flexible because it can connect to virtually any data source. And then the transformation of the data with M or Power Query, it's just a piece of cake. The challenge is when you start working with very, very, very large data sets and you're going across an entire enterprise, just a single semantic model may not work. You could run into some performance issues from a refresh perspective, right? It could slow down. It can increase the latency. And then you worry about scale. And then how do I govern every aspect of that semantic model? And one of the things that I see a lot and people don't think about is the duplication of semantic models or data in the semantic models. I've worked on projects where there's 8 semantic models and they almost have exactly the same data. But if you're working with a small set of data sources and you're building out a medium-sized project working with hundreds of millions, and I've even seen billions of rows of data with Power BI, it works. The next approach, and honestly, I didn't think about materialized views until recently when Microsoft announced materialized views in public preview. All you need to do with materialized views in Fabric is create a lakehouse and get the data into the lakehouse, whether it's through mirroring, whether it's through shortcuts, data flows, or data factory, or notebooks, or however you decide to get the data in the lakehouse. Then you use Spark SQL to create those views. There's some nuances with Spark SQL, like I'm a T-SQL person, but it's still SQL. SQL is just SQL, right? So let's say you're working with semi to unstructured data. You can get that in there. You can use Python to do some transformations of that data to get in the tables. And then you can use SQL to create all the logic and derive your schema from that. And it's flexible in a sense that if you have shifting schemas, if you're introducing new columns and new tables, it's easy just to go write a query, especially if you're working with a medallion architecture. You can just use materialized views as each one of those layers and quickly get it built without building infrastructure for all that. There's definitely advantages for improved performance, unified storage, very cost effective when it comes to compute, and you can have reusable logic across lots of tools. It does require knowledge of Spark, not immediately real time, because there's still some latency in getting that data there, and there's probably more setup needed for your BI integration. Then you can go home. Warehouse is where I started my BI journey, and so this is more of a rigid schema, and so I would extract the data out and I landed into this staging area. So now it's an additional storage, but then I use tools like SQL or data flows to transform my data and load my data into a star schema. Then I can use same tools to connect to it. It's a tried and true and tested solution that we've had on the books for a long time. Definite advantage to it, warehouses were built for BI. It's SQL based and it's familiar. It supports semantic modeling. I mean, we know Power BI loves a star schema and strong governance, because you can do a lot of validation of your data, but the same strong governance and rigidness of that data warehouse is the same disadvantages, because it requires a careful schema design and the storage costs could go up. You're keeping multiple copies of the data, the stage data and the actual data. It's less flexible for semi and unstructured data, because I do have to do some work to get it into my staging, to get it into my warehouse. And number four is the medallion architecture, which is the reason I did this video, because it seems like it's become the default architecture for most people, regardless of what they're trying to do. I'm going to say this, and this may cause a lot of controversy. We over-architect a lot of things. If we step back, take a breath and talk to the people that's requesting this project, we probably don't need all these layers. We probably don't need bronze, silver, gold. We probably just need to extract the data, put it in a place and allow them to consume it. Not saying that we don't need these, right? They're very scalable. It helps to improve data quality, especially as we go along those different stages of the data. We're constantly cleaning and refreshing that data. It supports a clear data lifecycle, and it is ideal for data engineering and machine learning and data science. The disadvantages though is that there's a lot of upfront planning and it can be really expensive and it could take a long time to build out this Lakehouse. I mean, if you have a really, really small window to get this out and get this going, a Lakehouse may not be the place you start. And it's a steep learning curve, to be honest. When I start building out my first Lakehouse, it took me a very long time because I'm writing Python and I have to learn Python. I got to learn about Spark. So when you think about designing your data solution, there's definitely three key things I think you should think about. What questions are you trying to answer? How are people going to discover the data? And the type and the number of data sources that you're connecting to. Once you have that worked out, then that should help you pick from these four choices. Or maybe you come up with a different choice. And I'm going to do videos on each one of these solutions and dive into more of these advantages and disadvantages. Stay tuned. We'll put them in a playlist and you'll be able to go check those out. All right. What do you think? Yeah. Any questions, comments? You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric and Power BI and Lakehouses and Warehouse, it's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam, Martha, and this guy, thanks for watching. And we'll see you in the next video.